KT made compositions like this look extraordinarily easy. It was with champions like Kha'Zix coming out of the jungle, things like that, champions that do have a little bit more damage behind them. The Sejuani is going to be different, but then Jace makes up for it on the top side of the map and is also a fantastic lane matchup. I like what KT have done, but once again, it's SKT knowing exactly what they want to do and then picking for that as well.
And the thing for KT is you like the draft. If it goes AP Galio, maybe there's enough damage from their Galio as well. But the caveat always is KT so rarely get all their chess pieces in order in the same game. In the same game where Smeb is popping off, Deft might be putting down a control ward, face checking and dying, they very rarely get everything together. But as a holistic draft, on paper, you love KT. On paper, you predict great things out of KT. But the paper gets ripped off, ripped up more often than not. So let's see if they can actually put that theory to practice.
Okay, we got a face check, guys. It's KT already using their flashes. Smeb's gonna be taken down.
So no pressure there. Also expecting the same sort of advantages early in the mid lane and also throughout the top lane matchup. We see Skor coming around. This is very nice pathing from him.
Yeah, teleport comes in. The hop is going to be there, but he's running out of gap closes. The flash is still up. Untara's going to have to use it, but Permafrost comes in and Smeb just picks up the kill.
Completely new for KT. Means that SKT should be ready.
Well, effort's in trouble. Blastcone's going to get him out of there, and they've now got a man advantage. Def gets over the wall, but Marta has to be careful. Rock entrance on top of Skor, and Marta's going to be able to pick up the kill. Bang! Seizes Death, and Smeb grabs the kill. Can we get KT moving up towards inner turrets now?
Doesn't end up being a massive value use of the Rift Herald.
Can't be a whole lot, but you can see the group up here from SKT might actually bite them as there's the ultimate coming out from Skor. In goes Pawn, picks it up all too easily.
In every other scenario, it's just a top-up. They want to continue with the pressure.
Yeah, charging back in. There's the Permafrost down onto Effort. In goes Pawn, wants to find the Taunt onto as many members as possible. Goes Golden with the Zhonya's as in goes Smeb, frontlining on the Jace because he's got the heroic entrance for the protection.
You see Deft, they put two and two together. Cannot complete the Baron, they just turn on to Deft.
Yeah, heroic entrance is going to be there though. Blank jumps all the way forward, but he's going to be taken out. That's the jungler! And KT now feels so much better taking this big purple monster.
And that's why you go for the Guardian Angel. You didn't notice a flash or a heal coming out. They were happy to power it down. All right, Skor, the smite's escaped you before. You need to hit it here.
This would be one hell of a steal if they do it without the smite, but he's going to be able to get it. Skor in his 400th game locks down the Baron. They kill Effort again. Buster Shot should be the disengage that SKT were looking
for.
But a teleport's going to come in. Untara, he's running for the hills, but he's not running.
All right, three waves of super minions propped up by another minute of Baron should happen here. They have Caitlyn. Should be straightforward. Let's see if KT can end.
Yep, Redemption comes in. Marta goes back up to basically full health. Deft is tanking up the turret. He wants to keep his minions alive by the looks of things. And these Nexus turrets not long for the world now. An exposed Nexus, XKT on the ropes. A game number one that KT have done in the past. Nexus is under fire, but it's the battle that we're looking at. Deft picks up one. We've got low health bars, and Smeb's just fighting Faker. The flash comes
minions.
Out. The minions are going to be enough, and the Nexus falls. KT, 9-1. Dominant early game, dominant mid game, and had all of the plays prepared this time. Nothing going to their head. Certainly being looked at as one of those at the same time. We're looking much closer to getting into the game.
Bang is 30-4 in his career. 30 wins, 4 losses on Kalista. Was undefeated for his first 25-plus games. It's been a pick for him, but recently he's prioritized things like Ezreal above it. Ezreal not available here. Lot of intriguing matchups. On paper, it seems like KT should be happy, and the Shyvana mid to late game, only Spirit has really unlocked. Game 2 of a telecom war. We've never had a 2-0 for KT with their current lineup since the start of 2017. They've never even won a best-of series, Atlas.
Potentially Blade of the Ruin King building Varus is an option, but the Cataclysm goes down on the bottom side. Deft is in trouble. We've got Unbreakable Will. Deft holds onto the flash and the heal for a long time. Marta, he's going to get out, but he doesn't have the ult anymore. That's four members of SKT. Marta will waste
now.
Their time, exactly. But four will be able to grab it. But look at Smeb and Skor. They'll take two turrets.
In a side lane this early against Ryze, the Ryze push-up vision into Realm onto Baron becomes possible.
Well, Pawn's actually looking for Faker. Emperor's Divide comes in, but here's the cavalry. Dragon's Descent flies forward. The flash after Faker. The Realm Walk to make sure that we've got a Rune Prison available. Flashes on top. Good double knockup from Blank, but it's all too late. Able to buy some space. Oh, the flash, not quite enough. Emperor's Divide will mean that Pawn's going to be in trouble. No more Stopwatch. No more opportunities. Hemoplague locks down Deft, and this is the SKT that we've been waiting to wake up. They grab the two picks, and this could mean Baron. Just tearing down turrets like it looks like they're doing right now. No smab available. No teleport for him either. And they, four of them, just watch as the turret falls down. There's a Cataclysm is blank. The Stopwatch is used, but he's in turret range. In goes Bang, and he's getting three shots. Score is going to be the first one down. They're under the turret. The two-man Empress Divide, and these will be all of those Ren stats being torn out. Pawn's going to fall. It's a triple kill for the Kalista, but Smeb is massive. Gets a brilliant wallop on top of Bang, but is it going to be enough? I don't think so. I think the base is still going to be broken.
Of 100% kill participation, it's 90% or above.
That's true.
For the entire team, team performance required. As Score is all alone.
Yep. 401 isn't exactly the best game for Score thus far. He's going to finally use the stopwatch and gets a little bit angry.
Really good stuff from KT. Reminds me of Kingzone yesterday, being able to turn it on the moment they got even a sniff of an opportunity. Marta's left all alone as SKT won even more than just the cow.
Yeah, Unbreakable Will's looking real breakable at this point, Papa Smitty. And it's just kill after kill. That was actually flashed from Marta used. Pawn having to use the ghost. Still able to move pretty quickly, but now it's that suffocation. It's that full power SKT knocking on your door. Super creeps, Baron buff, everything that they could possibly need. 2 minutes remaining of that purple aura. And Marta's just getting chunked. He will have to use the ultimate if he wants to try and start anything. Deft getting some decent damage, but he doesn't have the items that he had in the last game, and these turrets are getting smashed down. Blank jumps his way forward. Deft has to deal with that. Both turrets removed. Smeb's going to get destroyed. Score easily follows. Pawn trying to get damage down where he can, but Tal isn't even going to die. It's a triple kill for the god of the mid lane, and now they'll take down the Nexus. SKT will let it go the distance. It's a quadra in the end, and the king is back. Can be punishment early for the Vlad, but otherwise you just wait on a little while and everything is generally fine. This is two teamfight compositions, though, butting heads. Not this time do we see the teams with different identities moving onto the Rift, both of them wanting to gun for about similar timings of where they want to fight.
I want to see Score be really creative with the jungle jacks, the ability to path, the ability to gank from huge range that most other junglers can't, sort of maybe a Zac with some levels, gives you a lot of flexibility. I feel like he's the big wild card here. Otherwise, let's get down to business, Atlas. It's time to go to Game 3 of a Telecom War, one of the highlights of the year.
That's a decent maneuver. Faker's going to be spotted. Counter-Strike's going to be down. In goes Pawn. Picks up the kill. Faker caught shopping 2 weeks in a row. Oh, Faker's actually in trouble. Oh, not going to go into the Sanguine pool, so Pawn unable to bait that one out as there's the pool finally coming in. Oh, the Emperor's Divide, not enough. Cataclysm can't be cancelled. Pawn, Score, trying to get himself out, is going to move out of the way. Stopwatch is going to be used, gets out of the way of at least the ram. But speaking of getting rammed, he's going to get smacked on by Faker. Picks it up with a transfuse. Man in the mid lane gets some revenge.
I wonder if a game like this means we'll see more of Tal, as I'll hold the point for now.
Yep, Smeb is actually down here though, looking for his opportunity to get in there. There's the Nature's Call, getting himself on top. We've got the Ram coming back, nice double knock-up as it's Marta that falls down first. Score can't find his way in. There's the flash to get on top of the Kalista, and Pawn, he turns up as well. We've got Emperor's Divide being waited to be used. Can he get the priority targets though? Effort incredibly low. Pawn, lots of consistent damage, but the Shifting Sand's not going to get him too much further forward. In goes Faker. The Sanguine pulls there. Not going to find anything. Are the Sand Soldiers. And now it's Bang jumping forward. He's at full health. SKT have utilized so much depth. True Shot Barrage, so much damage. And that's going to be able to pick up Blank. There are still two dead though. KT don't have a lot of their damage available as Pawn has hit the death chamber. Sanguine pull once again, but I think the Faker might just fall here. Slowed down. Counter-Strike will be used in time. Yes, it will, and Score's going to be able to grab that kill. Faker being a little bit too tricky. There's a concussive blows. Deft having to be a little bit careful here. Dodges out of the way of one, but there's the Ornn. Marta having to use the Devour, but triple knock-up as the Pong gets bounced back. Another Emperor's Divide that's left a bit wanting. Flashes from everyone as Marta is going to be taken down. Deft already dead, and SKT should be able to move to a Baron. Yeah, remember, 26-minute Baron, not exactly the latest one in the game, so it's going down slowly. A lot of damage potential here from Pawn. They're actually going for it as Tahl makes his way in. They're committing to the Baron. They get rid of Tahl first. The Ren stacks are going to be torn out, but are they going to survive? 4 versus 3. KT getting kited for the moment. Blank able to wait for the flag and dragon. SKT, they sacrifice their top laner, but they get the Baron at 26 minutes. And unable to get the lockdown. And that's just a Brambleback that will be stolen away. In fact, leashed. As there's the call of the Forge God. They're looking for a good double knockup comes out from Tahl, but the Nature's Grasp is there. Faker right in the back line. The exhaust comes in and Tahl grabs the first kill on to score. SKT, another double knockup. Tahl's a massive beast on this Forge God himself. Will be taken down low though. That was a good Shurima shuffle coming in from Pawn. Make that a double kill, a triple. Pawn's turned it on, he's figured it out. And now Deft once more, he's got no health, but they want to clean this one up. Pawn, can he make it a quadra? Effort in trouble, unbreakable. It's not that unbreakable, sir, but we don't have the cooldowns and Pawn's not going to follow up. Now, KT with a little bit more reliable damage as well, I guess, as we move towards the late game. But Faker's trying to prove me wrong here. Hemoplague, we'll see how many people it's actually going to get on top of as Marta is going to be out, spit out Deft. They've got the Lock of the Iron Solari. It's doing some work. Smef, he's at really high health. Sand Soldier's doing work, but it's not anymore. Pawn's going to be taken down, and the Sanguine pulls in there. Make it now a triple kill for SKT. Call of Forge God doesn't find anyone though, as in goes Faker to get in round the back. There's the Cataclysm. Emperor's Divide is dodged by Faker. He has his Zhonyas as well, doing so much damage. But KT, they may have turned it around. Deft picks up the kill onto Faker, and now they're moving forward. SKT all grouped up. Sand Soldiers ripping them apart. And do we have the chase available? Score has the flash. He's got the Counter-Strike, but he gets slowed down. Marta, he's gone so far forward, and Smev is going to get delivered. Bang! Still dancing around the team fight. Remember, 4 versus 5. Make that 3. 5 versus 3, but Bang is still alive. In goes Score. They're looking for more. They get the pushback. Pawn in so much trouble under the turret, but Deft gets rid of Bang. This could be the ace for KT. SKT are aced. The Nexus turrets are taken down, and KT create history in 2018.